The arrival of a child is always a reason for celebration in the family. Everyone in the family, especially the couple, have been eagerly waiting for this moment. This moment which will change their lives forever. The child now becomes the focus of their lives. They shower all their love and affection on the new member of the family. As the days go by, the parents desire that their child would grow up to be all that they themselves could not become, grow stronger. The desire that he or she would become someone that they can be proud of. Every parent longs for the day to dawn when they can proudly say, "This is my son, my daughter." Surekha and Ajit Lele were no different. They too had dreams and aspirations about their child, Rama. But for reasons better known only to him, God chose to write their story differently. Rama was born a mentally handicapped child. It was a tough task for the parents to come to terms with this bitter truth. But as it is said, time is a great healer.
So I would say it took quite some time, maybe 2-3 years to accept that yes, we have a handicapped child and we'll have to live with her for a whole lifetime.
The years went by and the initial periods of trauma and frustration gave way to a feeling of hope. Hope for a better future for their child. They got together with other parents of similarly affected children. Everyone felt that these children were no different from others around them. Just like any other normal child, they too needed to be cared for, loved, and most importantly, be heard patiently.
See, there are difficulties even in bringing up normal children. So I think once you accept the fact, it is not that difficult.
We mainly saw that we don't need to, be ashamed of her or hide her. So we always decided that we'll take her along with us wherever we want to go. So, try to behave as much normally as possible. So that was the way we thought we'll raise her.
Maybe it would require a little more effort on the part of the parents and society. But a sincere effort is always worth the trouble. The Kamayani Center and the Bal Kalyan Sanstha in Pune run with this very belief in mind. While the Kamayani Special School was founded to help the mentally retarded children from all sections of the society in their all-round development, the Bal Kalyan Sanstha is a recreation center where children having various types of handicaps come from different schools in the city to spend their day. The one thing that is common, however, is that both are places where an attempt is made to add meaning to the lives of the less fortunate. The first lesson that the staff is given is to be patient with the child.
Basic idea behind this project is that all the disabled children, they should get all kind of facilities for their overall development through play and other recreational activities like art, craft, music, indoor, outdoor games, swimming and dance. Out of this, they should get the maximum enjoyment, joy, happiness, as well as with these co-curricular activities, they can develop their emotional, mental, physical, as well as social capacities.
It is only after one visits such places that one realizes that these children too have immense potential. They too are bubbling with energy. It's only a question of properly channelizing this energy.
घर का एटमॉस्फेयर जो होता है वो थोड़ा अलग होता है बच्चा जब स्कूल में जाता है तो उसे फील होता है कि ये सारे जो बच्चे मेरे आसपास है वो मेरे जैसे है तो वो बहुत कंफर्टेबल फील करता है इसके वजह से उसके साथ बातें करना वो मन से बहुत फ्रीली महसूस करता है तो ऑब्वियसली उसका बिहेवियर भी फ्री हो जाता है
स्कूल इज अ मस्ट फॉर एवरी चाइल्ड वेदर इज अ नॉर्मल और विद एनी हैंडीकैप And at home, one cannot give so much attention to any child. So, schooling is very necessary and you see a lot of improvement. After we put Rama in the school, within 6 months, she started talking very fluently.
She is very fond of school. And I think the atmosphere in school also teaches them discipline. And they learn to do many things in the school. And I don't think this kind of thing, you can get that effect by not sending the child to the school. So I think such special schools are very necessary.
The use of force, however, is a definite no. This is a golden rule that must be followed when dealing with mentally challenged individuals. An understanding of their mood is equally important. It is for this reason that even though the kids at Kamayani do follow a definite routine, which includes their daily prayers, followed by exercises like Surya Namaskar and their other classes, the timetable is subject to change depending on the mood of the children. Teaching through demonstrations and audiovisual aids rather than using the conventional chalk and board method also provides variety in the otherwise monotonous routine.
हा कोणता रंग आहे पिवळा एकदम बरोबर हा कोणता आहे निळा एकदम बरोबर कुठला रंग आहे हा लाल एकदम बरोबर
हिरवा
कुठला आहे
हिरवा
पिवळा कुठला रंग आहे हा
हिरवा
पिवळा म्हणायचा याला बरोबर आहे हा कुठला रंग आहे
निळा
निळा एकदम बरोबर हे काय आहे
काकडी
बरोबर हे काय आहे
मुली
पिवळा
A mentally disabled child differs from the normal child by the fact that his mental growth does not keep pace with his physical growth. He may be 18 years old, but mentally he may behave like a child of 4. This is a very important aspect that has to be kept in mind when dealing with mentally handicapped people. It is for this very reason that any new case that comes to the school is kept under observation for 3 weeks. The child psychiatrist evaluates the case after the observation period. If found suitable, the child is then admitted to a class in accordance with his or her mental age. Just as in the case of any normal child, for the handicapped child also, going to school for the first time is a different experience altogether. It means adjusting to a new environment and making new friends. Once made to feel comfortable, however, these children too can excel, not only in their academics, but in extracurricular activities as well. Who could say that these drawings and paintings on display were the work of someone who is not mentally sound? Seeing these children at work, who could not help but wonder whether there is a budding artist in them? The songs and music that you hear are not coming from classes of any music school. These are coming from the hearts of these kids whom we choose to call mentally handicapped. In fact, the teachers at Kamayani school have found out that the mentally retarded children are very much fond of the cultural programs and music. No wonder that with a little guidance and encouragement, one class presents a cultural program every Friday. It's a delight to know that these kids conduct all activities themselves, right from the introduction to the vote of thanks. The school even has its own orchestra. So one can see that proper guidance, attention, and understanding can bring out the best in these children. But what is important is that this guidance and understanding of their needs must not come only from their parents or teachers, but from all quarters of society.
Disabled children are the part of the entire society. They should be also treated as equal as any other normal human being, and society should be aware of the limitations of disabled children persons as well as abilities they have, so that society can also contribute and make them more independent, happy and self-employed individuals.
It is pretty disheartening, however, to find that the students are usually left to while away their time at home once they finish their education or attain 18 years of age, at which time the law says that they cannot continue in special schools. The need of the hour is to realize the fact that they are not a burden on society. As they grow older, they can be trained in vocational fields like tailoring, weaving, printing, working on simple press machines, painting and sculpting. This would not only make their rehabilitation easier, but would make them an asset to their families and society. For being accepted in any industry, they need to be trained to perform 8 hours of actual work, as is expected from any other normal individual. Once this is achieved, it is easy for them to find work in various manufacturing units. It is encouraging to know that over the last 20 years, almost 55 individuals from the Kamayani workshop have found employment outside. The need is not to consider them as a separate entity of society, but to encourage normal individuals to come forward and mingle with their less fortunate friends. This will go a long way in building their confidence and help them in their all-round development. When this happens, parents like Surekha and Ajit would not have to worry about having to bring up a handicapped child. Institutions like Kamayani, the Bal Kalyan Sanstha and the society in general would be there to lend a helping hand.